Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's look at using the Ken Burns effect in iMovie. So I'm using iMovie 10 and we're going to take a close look at the Ken Burns effect. The Ken Burns effect can be used with video, but it's most often used to enhance still photos in videos. And by default you probably have it turned on. So you drag and drop a photo like I have done here and you have the Ken Burns effect, which makes the photo kind of zoom in or out depending upon which way you've got it. So let's take a look by clicking adjust and then going to cropping, and then here you can see it is set to Ken Burns. And we've got a start rectangle and an end rectangle, and we can adjust either one of these. So for instance, for a dramatic effect we can zoom in here and have it start on one of these faces here like this, and then we could have it end showing the whole group like this. And now when we preview it here, we'll move the playhead back and we'll preview it, we'll see how it does that. So there's a lot you can do. Now, for instance, on the second photo here, you may want to have it start pretty wide and then end by zooming in here. And this is a pretty high-res photo, so this should work really well. We can close the adjust window here and then scrub across and see exactly what's going to happen there. Now you can very easily reverse a Ken Burns effect, swapping start and end there. So now we can see the reverse there. So it comes in very handy for centering in on something or moving out from something in a video. And it helps photos come alive. And you can do the same thing with a moving video. So let's look at that. For instance, if I were to take this video clip here, move it to the beginning, and I could set the cropping to Ken Burns and have it start very close and then move out. And now the video, while it's playing, is changing its cropping. And one of the reasons you don't see very often with video is the resolution of the video. When you zoom in, it's not that great, because usually zoomed all the way out, that's the best resolution matching what you're doing. And then zoomed in, you're actually just magnifying in on pixels, so it gets a little blurry. One of the things I'd like to do with the Ken Burns effect is to be able to show a large object in more detail. So let's look at this here. We've got a lighthouse and we can set it so that it starts at the base of the lighthouse and then ends with the top. And then we may want to go ahead and increase the duration of this. 4 seconds is probably too short. So now when we play it, we get a nice detailed look at the lighthouse, even though the resolution of video isn't anywhere close to that of photos. You still get a lot of good detail in as you watch that happen. And you get the same thing here with this final photo I've got in here. This is actually a panoramic photo. If I would go in here and look at the cropping and I would set it to fit, you can see it's just a very long, narrow photo. It's going to give me black bars at the top and bottom, and I won't be able to see much great detail. These photos are becoming more common now that you can take them with the iPhone. So using a Ken Burns effect here, where you know I start at the left and move to the right, and create a nice looking effect as you pan across the scene like this. So for one final trick, let's return to this video here where we've got three faces. And let's say we want to go from one to the other, then to a third. That would be kind of neat. So let's do that here, and we'll just go from one to two. And we'll do that over the period of, say, 8 seconds. So we have 8 seconds going from one to the other. Now we can preview that and see how that goes from one to the other. And it will be nice to continue to go to the third face, and we can do that by basically taking this clip here, going to copy it, going to paste it, and it's going to duplicate it here, but then I'm going to go into the cropping here and I'm going to reverse so I have start and end it's going to be start, and it's going to start on this face here, which is where we ended, and I'm going to go down to this face. So we have it picking up and carrying on. Let's take a look what happens now when we scrub past all of this. We go from one face to this face and this face down to this face. And you can just keep going with that. I could take this, I could copy, I could paste it, and I could have it go back to the original. Flip it like that and have it end there. So if you could do it, the whole bunch of faces or objects, all sorts of things, using a little trick plus the Ken Burns effect.